go, Billy. Glad you were able to make it.
What are you so anxious to see me about, Dave?
Come up to my room where we can talk.
Doesn't that Billy Carson you just rode up?
Yeah. I wonder what he's got to do with it.
Dave, what's it all about?
I got a job for you, Billy.
A job? Have a heart. I thought you were a friend of mine.
I don't think you'd find a way too hard for your delicate constitution. Now, this map shows the route the railroad has decided upon.
Oh, it runs right through Red Rock, huh?
Mm-hmm.
It makes Fuzzy happy.
Who's Fuzzy?
Fuzzy Jones, you remember, my old partner?
Old Fuzz likes to be important.
He's a big man for that little one-house town in Red Rock. The railroad going through there, it'll start a boom.
We have to find someone we can trust to buy a right-of-way through here at a fair price before anyone learns about the railroad. That's why I sent for you.
I'd like to help you, Billy, but I'm no good at dickering for land.
Nothing very excited about. Well, what do you say, Billy? Will you take the job?
Kind of out of my line, Dave. I'm no good at horse trading. Hey, listen, I've got an idea. Fuzzy's the man that you want. He's honest, you can trust him, he's right there on the ground.
Sounds all right to me.
Well, Fuzzy's sure going to be happy with that new job of his.
For his pockets and find the key to this satchel.
And I don't know who killed Dave, but I think I know why. There was a map in this statue. It isn't here now. I have a good idea where that murder will be heading.
Surely someone's found Hanley by this time.
Well, what if they have? He won't be able to tell who shot him. Well, boys, we hit the jackpot this time. We're moving right in on Red Rock. Come on.
The finest bath that I ever had. Ever since I was in 2 years old, I figured that I'd always have a bath when I... what'd you do that for? I've always been...
Now break it up.
Fired
ours.
Chester! Did you say anything?
Yeah, but you were going to.
Now, give me the pipe.
Have you got keys for $10?
$10, mm-hmm.
No, I made a mistake. The fine is $10. Now get out of here. Behave yourself. Nick?
You can't do that. Get back in the chair. Next. Next. Good, next.
Hi, Fuzzy.
Hey, sure, you're next.
How's everything?
Not bad.
Must be beautiful, Fuzzy. I got some high-powered sparking to do.
That bad dust, you can sure make a man give out with sparks.
You know, I've been reading up on the marriage ceremony. Hoping I'd have a chance to meet her pretty soon.
You and me both. I got her past note, maybe.
She kind of shies away from yes.
Say, Red Rock's kind of coming to life.
Yeah, the strangers bought Pop Turner's saloon,
making a gambling house out of it.
Gambling house?
Yeah.
They can't do that without my say-so.
Well, there you go.
I'll be right back.
Hey, look.
What about my haircut and shave?
Oh, take it easy. I'll be back in a minute.
Yeah, but I got it.
Pack this stuff and get out of here. There ain't nobody opening the demo place around here without my face up.
A little man, you open your mouth too wide.
Yeah, when I open my mouth, I say something. When I say something, I mean it.
Don't you ever get tired of doing that?
No, this is my way of working up an appetite.
Well, I'd ought to take care of him.
The idea of busting in here like that?
I was just passing by and your boy started to play a little rough.
Haven't I seen you someplace before?
Well, it could be. Lots of people have seen me. I've been around.
I don't have my mind about you and this outfit, but I'm going to single over.
Yeah. Says he can do some plenty high and fancy thinking when he wants to.
I imagine he can.
We'll be open soon. Drop in if you feel lucky and give us a whirl.
I might do that.
Well, you gonna be a barber? Stop jumping around like a flea on a hot grill?
Oh, keep your shirt on.
I'm a busy man.
Oh, I want you to meet a friend of mine, Billy Carson.
Howdy.
Hi. This is Clay Kincaid. He's a nice fella, but flies off the handle a little too easy.
I wonder if he's drowned.
Hey, wake up.
Yourself and get out. Not hang around here like a hippopotamus. The next time you take a bath, put your spurs on.
Well, you just said that on the spur of the moment, didn't you?
Hey, Fred, what are you doing in your spare time?
I'm a doctor.
You're a what?
Horse doctor.
Now, we've got to have this part of the Kincaid Ranch. That's the key to the whole valley.
So do we buy them out or let them out?
I don't know. I'll have to see how things work out.
I'm sure glad you happened along when you did. What brings you out here to our neck of the woods?
Oh, I just dropped in to see what you had.
You're looking for excitement. Came to the wrong place.
Maybe I can stir up some of my own excitement. There's plenty of sweet smelling stuff you have here, Fred. It's kind of different than what you find around the bend, girl.
Yeah.
Some of the scenery's mighty easy on the eye.
Howdy, Miss Babs. I'm glad to see you.
Hello, Buddy. My horse lost his shoe. Would you pick it for me?
Well, no, I'm a pretty busy man. Even if I were twins, I'd... You wouldn't do enough of me. Maybe Billy can help us out. Hey, Billy. Miss Babs, Dorothy, Billy Carson.
How do you do?
I'm glad to meet you.
I can do that job for you, Miss Babs, if you'd like to.
Well, that's very kind of you. My horse is outside.
Goodbye, Fred.
Well, Billy gives every female heart a fur. When they look at him, they get a light in their eyes.
Very interesting.
Oh, don't worry about Billy. He'll never settle down. Well, it ain't worth a dime a dozen to him.
I really won't change his mind.
He wouldn't do that to me. No.
You don't need all those reins, Len. I'll give you a good price for it and the privilege of driving your cattle across it any time you want to.
I told you before, I'm not selling an acre. I don't need any cash.
Oh, all right. If that's the way you feel about it, that's the way it is. Say, I'm open for business. Drop in any time you feel lucky.
This is the boundary between our reins and the Kincaid Ranch. Say, that's Clay Kincaid over there.
Who's that with him?
I don't know. He doesn't look familiar.
The idea. Starting a fight in front of a lady is no way to act.
I didn't know I'd any quarrel with him. But it makes me sort of mad when he rides up on a horse and knocks me down.
You stay away from Babs. You're going to have plenty of quarrel with me.
I'll take my own sons without asking for your permission.
I know all about him. He thinks he's a rip-snorting lady killer.
Who gave you that information?
From a guy that's known you for a long time. Fuzzy Jones.
Fuzzy? I'm going to have to wash his mouth out with some of his own shaving soap.
Don't get the idea that you're my boss. But I never want to see you again if you can't act like a gentleman. Would you mind taking me home?
Yes, ma'am. I'd be glad to.
a woman is just like a spirited horse. You can't handle them with a tight rein.
Now, get out of here, boy. Start
just
rumoring.
Well, I'm sorry, Fuss. Working kind of late tonight, aren't you?
Yeah, and I'm closed up for the night. Hey. You've been hanging around Red Rock here for about a week. And I know you ain't doing it for your health. Now, what's on your mind?
I'm looking for a murderer, Fudge.
A murderer?
Uh-huh. Expect to find him right here in Red Rock, too.
A murderer? Oh, my God. Hey, Fudge. Hey, Fudge. Hey, hang on a minute, will ya?
Hey, Fudge. Where are you going?
I'm going to catch that murderer.
Now, you listen to me. Don't you make a move until I tell you what to do. You can mess things up by going off half-cocked worse than anybody I ever knew.
Yeah, but I know on Red Rock.
Sure, and I bet the worst criminal you ever ran up against was a chicken thief.
Chicken thief?
That's right. You know, you'll have to find that things are going to be a lot different around here from now on.
You think so?
Yes, I think so.
How about you?
You? All right,
but I invented this game.
That's going to make a puzzle on me.
You do.
Be a little dumb, but whatever gave you the idea that a one-horse town like Red Rock could support the kind of a layout you've got here.
You know, I like to open up a place where there's no competition. And when the town grows, I'm sitting pretty.
Oh, sounds like good sense to me. And whatever gave you the idea that the town would grow?
I don't like to have people too curious about my business.
I'm sorry to seem nosy. I didn't mean to be.
You're bad. My last 50. I'll see you. What do you got?
Two pair of loops and
oh, good. 3/8.
Hey, did you take my ride with you?
You'll have to talk to Steve.
Well, I just dropped in to get acquainted. I'm going out and look some of the games over. Maybe I can take some of your money.
Well, you're welcome to try. That's what I'm here for.
Am I good for 500?
Yeah, sure. Just make out an hour, you.
You know, I figured out a foolproof way of beating this game, but something's going wrong someplace.
Let's go. Let's give me pay that 500.
Okay.
We'd better do something about Carson. He's showing too much curiosity about things that are none of his business.
Yeah, and I owe him something for nearly breaking my jaw.
Well, it's more than a broken jaw that I have in mind for him. And I don't like the interest he showed when he found one of these broken matches in front of the bar. He acted like it was important.
Give me another stack of chips there.
That'll cost you 25.
I got a call.
Two nights straight.
Hey, look, my luck's bad enough without you, Jason. Go stand someplace else, will you?
There's no reason for you to act like that.
Get yourself
Now, you calm down, Clay Kinkale. I'm a 50 caliber. I ain't having no part in this town.
So keep this fellow away from me, then.
Have it that way if you like. Anybody's privileged to make a fool of themselves.
I just calm down. I ain't fast for no pardon.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised if Kingfield turned out to be a lot of help to us.
You know, folks, everything points to one man. I've got to find out whether Steve Lando has a certain map in his position.
Well, what did you ask him?
Red Rock's always been a clean and peaceable place, and I aim to keep it that way. But I got a feeling that something's brewing.
Oh. Howdy, Miss Bud.
Bobby, I'm worried about Clay. The accountant is gambling like a crazy man, and he's already lost more than he can afford. Can't you do something?
Well, he's always been a stubborn cuss and wouldn't accept advice. Maybe if you talk to him.
I won't talk to him. Not until after he's apologized for the way he acted.
Well, maybe I can talk some sense into him.
I'll try.
Oh, thanks, Fuzzy. I hope you can. Even if we're not friends anymore, I hate to see Clay make a fool of himself.
That's why I don't like gamblers. They can sit there and take the shirt off a man's back and think nothing of it.
Oh, never mind the sermon. We don't drag anyone in and make them play. And we can go out the door any time they feel like it.
Hey! What'd you do? What'd you do?
Just never mind. There was new soap, you know, it's slippery. I dropped my razor down. Hold it back here.
Don't wiggle around so much.
I'll
If you cut me that razor and ruin my clothes, I'll blast you wide open.
don't wiggle around so much. Now, get out. Get the
gun.
I got it. What's this?
Take it easy now.
Yeah, I got it.
Don't you cut me.
There you are. Not a rip or a scratch.
Lucky for you.
Hi, Billy. Hey, come up over here. Sit down. You're next.
What happened to him, Fred?
I dropped my razor down this back of the neck, and when I went to fish it out, I sort of had an accident.
Hey, well, you stopped me hard like a half-witted boy. Maybe you'll tell me how you've been making out.
That's a good question. Afraid I was going to have to do a little job of burglarizing.
Burglarizing? Uh-huh. Well, I can't stand for that. I've got to pull the roll.
All right. I'll hide your marshal badge before I start.
Is that your idea of a joke? Well, I'll give you something to laugh about.
You've traveled a long way to get yourself into trouble, mister.
You heard what I said.
Calm down. There's no cause for all this. I'm thinking different. Take a look at my coat.
I'm sorry. Well, that was an accident.
You'll make it good.
He better, and I'll take it out of his hide.
You can give this back to your friend. Tell him you better be careful. You might get in a lot of trouble. Now go on, beat it.
You know, Clay Kincaid's been losing a lot of money lately.
I noticed that. Also noticed he was up against a lot of fancy dealing.
Why did you put him in
line? I bet in line, but he wasn't what you'd call right friendly. How can you help a man when he's always swinging at your jaw all the time?
Hey, what's the matter? Don't you like our bed?
No, it's lonesome in there.
Come in. Hello, Kincaid. Did you come in to settle up?
Nope, not exactly.
What do you mean, not exactly?
I haven't got much cash on hand. I think it's good.
Well, you can settle the bet right now by dealing me that piece of property I noticed.
Well, then you're right. I'm not chopping up my ranch.
And I'm not in business to collect these autographs. I let you play on the cuff, and I expect you to pay off. You know, I have a way of taking care of a welcher.
Careful who you call a welcher. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll put that property up as security that you get your money.
That's fair enough. Suppose we put that in writing.
Okay with me.
And let's have the judge draw it up nice and neat.
Maybe you like it wrapped in pink ribbon.
I'll get along without the ribbon.
What do you mean when he's planning to do some burglarizing?
Well, Fred, you were the kid, Abraham. He stole a map from his grip. I have an idea I'll find that map in Steve Lander's office.
Hiya, Dad.
You know the old saying, unlucky at cards, lucky in love. Doesn't seem to pan out in your case.
Yeah?
I hear that Billy Carson's got a reason right out of his home.
I'm not interested in what you hear.
Hey, Fuzzy! Come here!
I wish I could start something sometime and not be bothered or finish it. All right, I'm coming.
What do you want?
Got a legal job for you.
Security for the money I owe Landry.
There's clearly you in your right mind.
Look, I didn't ask you for your opinion. Just make out the papers.
Keep you happy when the luck changes.
Thanks.
I wouldn't count too much on this change of luck if I were you.
Hey, calm yourself, Clay. There won't be any gunplay in that just now. Look, you hung around long enough. Now it's time for you to move on.
That just happens to be your opinion.
I'm backing up my opinion. Now make tracks or eat smoke. If I see you around here tomorrow, start shooting.
Seems like you're going to be kept busy for a while.
Not very.
What are we going to do about Clay?
What are you expecting to do? He called a play.
Oh, I know Clay. Hot-tempered and flies off the handle easy, but he's a nice fella.
A nice fella can kill you just as dead as anybody else.
You two boys locked up. I'm leaving.
All right. Good night, Steve. Good night.
Did you hear anything?
No. You better not drink any more of that stuff or you'll be seeing things.
It was dark in here, and he moved too fast for me to get a good look at him.
What was the answer?
I don't know.
What's the matter, boys? Been having trouble? I heard gunfire.
Ooh, they sure tore things up around here, didn't they?
You wouldn't be knowing anything about it, would you?
Me? Why should I know anything about it?
I'm asking you the questions. You answer them. Maybe you thought I was fooling when I told you to keep your nose out of my business.
Could be that you're nervous about something and just imagined that I'm interested in your business.
You know, I could imagine that you had a very fatal accident.
And that would take a pretty strong imagination, because I've always been lucky about not having any accidents.
You could overplay your luck.
Shooting's all over, Fudge. I guess we'd better be going.
We can't fool with Carton any longer. He's got to be put out of the way.
What you said, Kincaid's anxious to take the job off our hands.
Oh, Kincaid hasn't got a chance with Carton. Unless we help him. Hey, we might finish Kincaid at the same time. I've got the mortgage. You can take over the property just as soon as he's dead. Glad that the mortgage was here and what he was after. Well, maybe it was Kincaid.
You sure made a mess of things at the start.
You didn't have to have a gun in my face.
I didn't know who it was.
I left you here asleep. You should know whose face it is before you start pumping guns into it. I nearly got myself all shot up trying to help you out and all for nothing.
You're wrong about that, Ben. Thanks to you, we did it the hard way. But I saw Landro put a paper in his pocket. I'm sure it's a map I'm looking for.
Oh, why did you grab him then and there?
Because I didn't want to run into a gunfight with the odds against us. I'm going to take him alive. How about a sheriff?
Just tell him, right?
Why not?
Oh, all right. Get in the chair.
You know, Landro's going to be nervous about that map, Fudge. He's going to keep it in his pocket. I'm going to wait my chance to get him alone and sneak him out of town before his gang gets wise. I'll save a lot of bloodshed. Hey, Fudge.
Yeah?
You know, I'm worried about placing Cade. I don't want to hurt the crazy fool, and I don't want him taking pot shots at me. It's going to be your job to keep that fella out of town.
I reckon I can handle that all right.
All the shooting?
I don't know, but whoever it was didn't stick around.
Looks like we started something,
Bud. Is that good?
No, not very.
Maybe. I might have a package to deliver to the sheriff in Limerick.
Couldn't you send it by express?
Not very well. Not that kind of a package.
You know, I never was engaged to Clay Kincaid. He had no right to act as though I belonged to him.
You can't hang a man for hoping.
man seemed to be afraid to hope for some reason or another.
Hey, you got to come with me and help me catch a wrestler.
You must be dreaming. There hasn't been a wrestler in this valley for 20 years.
No?
Well, there may be.
You can help me hunt, can't you?
Look, I don't want to play any games. I got serious business in town.
Oh.
You ain't going to town.
It's going to take more than you to stop me.
Now, I'm going to sit right here until you promise me you'll go home and stay there.
Hey, what's going on?
What's the idea?
Trying to keep me going to town.
Well, I'm not surprised. Carson was saying that you talk big, but you wouldn't show up in town.
Yeah? He doesn't know how wrong he is.
I have to be leaving you now, Miss Babs. I got to see a man about a murder.
Yourself out of this. Now get going. Miss Babs, have you seen Clay?
Well, sure, he's in the saloon.
Oh, brother.
You worked yourself up into a lavick and gave me all over nothing. And you're being played with for a sucker. I don't want any trouble with you. But I'm not going to let you stand in the way of a job I came here to do.
Thank you.
fella. This is gonna hang you.
You'll be all right. I just sent you to the doctor.
Oh, Craig. You hurt bad.
Come on, Fred, let's look for it. Come on, stop. Stop playing, will you? What happened to you?
Pardon me, are you wearing a necktie?
Yeah. Tyson Kidd had a near escape. Doc packed him up, and now he's getting as good as new.
Himself all shot up, but Babs and Clay back together again. But that ain't my way of courting.
I guess you don't know what I want. I'll have to try some other place.
Two of the finest men ever lived, and he don't like them.
Hey, Fudge! Fudge, come in here!
Congratulations.
Yeah,
just
one,
I'll be
right with you. Yeah, been hoping for this. Now, you're charged with intent to commit matrimony. Guilty or not guilty?
Guilty.
Obtain a kind of mortgage on a piece of property, you have to... Wrong book. Wrong hand.
Maybe it's a cute way to finish a story.
Flattering those wanted signs all over this new county.
It's lucky we found out about them before we tried to settle in these parts.
You can say that again. Why is it every time there's a crime committed any place in the state, they drag out their printing presses and blame it on the Billy?
Because you're always hiding behind them whiskers.
Why, you low down...
Here comes the stage. Just in time. Hey, take a look.
We won't need these now.
You're not going to let those umbrellas interfere?
No, it's unethical. We're the ones that are going to do the interfering. Come on.
Are you all right, Miss Janet?
Yes, I'm all right, but there's something wrong with the sheriff.
Looks like the sheriff's been shot. Thanks, fellas.
That was nothing.
The sheriff's been shot. Likely we'd all been killed if you hadn't happened along.
Lucky we did happen along.
First, I thought that was Kansas.
Is Kansas a friend of yours?
It's my fiancé.
Oh, well, that does make him a friend. I've never met Kansas. Only one I know is Sloan. He sent for me to run the gambling tables at the casino.
Well, Kansas has a deep scar on his forehead, but I said that you'd swear those two were twins. Sure give me a shock at first.
I should think it would. Be careful. That whiskered fellow's watching us.
Whoever that fella is, he's a dead ringer for Ed.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Ed ain't gonna like the way this thing turned out.
I'll say he ain't. That gold's still on the stage.
Maybe it ain't too late.
Wait. He's coming out.
Is he dead? Shot through the back. That's funny. What about those two?
Worry about those later.
Is he done for?
Yeah.
He must have stopped a stray bullet.
Plenty stray. Straight through the back.
Through the back?
If you don't mind, I'm anxious to get to Sage Valley. Can we continue this investigation when we arrive there?
Sure, let's get going.
Yeah, come on, let's get out of here.
Wait a minute. Say, do you mind telling me your name?
Why, no, ma'am. My name is Billy.
Billy what?
Just plain Billy.
Thank you, Billy.
Everybody in?
Yep.
Thanks again, fellas.
Go ahead. We're driving in town with you.
Come on.
You just heard.
What do you make of it, Bill?
That sheriff wasn't killed by any straight bullet. Came from inside that coach.
Yeah, I didn't like the looks of that gambler fellow. No one with him. They and the girl were the only ones riding inside.
The guard could have done it. Fired down from the seat.
Might as well count the driver in. Maybe the girl, too.
Yeah. Wonder why she kept asking my name.
Here we go again. What's eating you, Fuss?
Plenty. Anytime you two fellows start speculating, that's just when we start sticking our noses in trouble. Let the dead sheriff stay dead. There's plenty of live ones now. Anyway, I thought we were going after them posters.
That's what we're going to do right now. Come on.
Fellas look enough like you, your brother.
I ain't got no brother. Forget it. What happened?
Well, it happened just as we told you. Them fellas come riding up shooting and there's nothing else we...
Take it easy, Kansas.
Yeah, take it easy.
What do you want?
I came to see you about Harrison.
About Harrison? What about him?
Well, he refuses to renew the lease on the casino.
Refuses, eh? Now get this, all of you. Harrison's next. I want that money in his bank, and I want him out of the way. From now on, I'm taking things over. Gonna make sense. Now get out. All of you.
Sit down, will you, Fussy? You'll wear yourself out.
Always curious and speculating.
First thing you know, we're going to be up to our necks in trouble.
Why don't we get while the getting's good?
Wouldn't be glad to run out in the mayor.
Besides, he said he had something important to talk to us about.
I ain't trouble with manners when I smells trouble. I tell you, I sees that guard took them posters into the sheriff's office. I didn't tell you when I go in there to look for him.
He's gone. A bit of 100 of buttons, he's got them in there somewhere.
Quiet. I'm telling you for the last time, Sloan, I won't renew your lease on the casino.
You're not trying to tell me, Harrison, that you think I run a crooked wheel.
I certainly am. I don't mind the ranchers having some fun, but when I find out that they're being robbed, it's my duty to protect them.
Now, if I were you, I'd be careful what I said.
Parking pause.
That guy is taking a long time with the fella.
Yeah. You listen to what I'm saying. This town will soon become the county seat. But before that happens, you and your gang are clearing up.
That's what you think.
Get out! Get out!
You asked for it, Harrison.
You wait here.
You all right, Mr. Harrison?
Yes. Yes, thank you.
Haven't I seen you someplace before we met this morning?
No, I don't think so.
I swear I've seen you someplace.
Haven't been in these parts before.
You sure?
Positive.
Well, I guess I must be mistaken. You know, it's funny how you think that you've seen a strange face before.
Yeah, that is funny.
Oh, come in, you fellas. Make yourself comfortable.
Thanks.
I guess I'm indebted to you twice.
Yeah. Wasn't nothing?
Well, I'll have to differ with you there. You saved my money on the stage this morning, and now you saved my life.
Glad to be of service. Mr. Harrison, you said you wanted to talk to us about something.
Yes, I did. What you told me this morning about the sheriff being shot in the back was verified by the coroner. Now, the sheriff was my best friend.
It was dirty fighting, whoever it was.
Yeah, it was one of the lowest tricks I ever used.
There's a lot of dirty things going on around here. That's what I wanted to talk to you about. How would you like to have a job working for me?
Yeah, that's a course.
Well, the pay will be good, and I'm sure you'll like the work. Can I see him in a jet? Oh, sure, Tim, sure. Come on in. Well, what do you mind, Tim?
Well, I want to see you private.
Speak right up. These boys are good friends.
Well, it's about those IOUs.
Just a minute. I'll explain to the boys. Sloan, our recent visitor here, runs the casino across the street. He's taken in Tim and a lot of other ranchers with a crooked roulette wheel. And now he's got their IOUs.
And he's demanding his money pronto, or he wants a lien on our ranchers.
Well, you go back to Sloan and tell him I'm buying up all the ranchers' IOUs. And I warn you, Tim, if I ever catch you gambling again...
Jed, you don't need to worry about me. And I reckon the rest of us have learned our lesson. And thanks again for everything.
That's all.
I'll be seeing you fellas around.
Right.
See Sloan's game? He's ruthless and he'll stop at nothing to gain control of this town. I must get rid of him and his gang peaceful-like.
Why peaceful-like? There's only one way to deal with cutthroats.
Yeah, you said it.
Yes, you're right. It's important right now to have law and order. Sage Valley has got to have a new sheriff. Now, I'm a pretty good judge of men. And if what you did today is any sample, you're the man for the job. Now, what do you say?
Nothing, sir. That's way out of my line.
Oh, nonsense. You can handle it all right. I'll think it over. Don't be too hasty in refusing. Decide later. Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Now, what's your name?
My name... Billy.
Last name?
Billy Bennett. Billy Bennett.
Billy Bennett?
Yes, sir. Billy Bennett.
Here's an authorization of your appointment as Sheriff of Sage Valley.
I can't take this, Mr. Harrison.
Nonsense. Put it in your pocket and think about it tonight and let me know tomorrow. Well, goodbye, Sheriff.
Not me, sir. Being a sheriff is one thing I don't want to know anything about. Bye, sir.
Bye.
Hey, don't let him kid you. He knows more about sheriffs than any man in the state.
All right, you hyenas. What's so funny?
Billy's a kid sheriff. Oh, that's funny, funny.
Go on, have your fun. But I bet you this. Bet you'll make a better sheriff than a lot of those hyenas I've seen wearing badges.
Why, that's a cinch.
Hey, we better pull out. There's going to be plenty of trouble around here when those posters show up.
Guys,
You killed him. He tried to draw on me.
I saw the whole thing.
Me too. Plain case of self-defense.
Glad it's more than that. He even tried to tear up his IOUs.
Money that he owed me.
Tim was in my office a short while ago. He didn't have any gun then.
No. Well, you look. He's got one now.
I don't believe you, Sloan.
You know I'm getting mighty tired of your talk, Harrison.
Maybe so. But I've got just one more thing to say. I'm settling for all the ranches IOUs, and I want you off these premises by the first. That's 10 days.
A lot can happen in 10 days.
Too much has happened.
And as for you, you know a man can get really hurt interfering in other people's business.
Is that a warning?
Yeah. It's a warning for you to get out of Sage Valley and stay out. Those fellas make 3 more on our list.
Yeah.
Well, I'll see you boys later. In the meantime, take over my office.
Good luck to you, Mr. Harrison.
Harrison fell for it. Too beat it. He'll need your help.
Have a look around.
Nick, let me have your gun.
Better idea. Come on.
Mind telling the fellow where you're going?
Let's call it Barbara, honey.
That wagon open.
Shot bad.
Get out from there.
We
gotta get him to town quick.
He's dead, is he?
Got a chance.
Them outlaws held me up and took Harrison's money. Well, I couldn't help it. Them bandits' guns sticking at me is wonder I wouldn't kill.
It's a wonder I don't kill you right now.
Now make tracks. If I catch you around this neck of the woods again, you'll eat more lead than you can digest.
Yeah, and that goes for me, too.
Jeff, you take my horse. We gotta get him to a doctor quick.
I'll drive.
Doc said you'd be good as new in a couple of weeks, Mr. Harrison.
A couple of weeks? Do you realize what that'll mean?
Well, yes. Getting your health back is important.
But Sloan and his gang will take over.
Maybe you won't have things so easy.
Billy, you've just got to reconsider. You've got to help me make Sage Valley a decent, respectable community.
No, but I can't get a job. Isn't there a ranch around here that can handle it?
You saw what happened to Tim Pine.
Yeah. Oh, I wish I could help you.
Would you sit down? You're making me nervous.
Yeah? How do you suppose I feel? No telling what Billy's doing in there.
Well, there's one way to find out.
Yeah?
How? Wait till he gets out.
Maybe you're right.
Come on, we got a job to do.
Where are we heading?
To the casino.
I am dreaming all alone of the man who broke my heart. He made me leave a happy home for my friends I had to part.
Oh, right now.
I am dreaming all alone of the man who broke my heart. He made me leave a happy home for my friends I had to part.
No. I think it's down here.
When his kiss is cold to me, told it cold, I feared from the start.
Looks like there's going to be a new sheriff.
Yeah, looks like it.
I reckon you don't have to change your mind now.
Say, Bill, what's gotten into you? Ever since you came out of Harrison's, you've been acting strange. Close mouth as a clam.
Yeah. I thought you said we had a job to do.
We do have a job to do.
I hope I'm not intruding.
No, no, not at all. As a matter of fact, I've been wanting to talk to you. You remember Fuzzy and Jeff?
Yeah, hello.
Won't you sit down?
Thank you. Well?
Did you notice anything strange when the sheriff was shot? In the coach, I mean.
What do you mean, strange? He drew his gun and he suddenly slumped over.
What were the others doing?
Why, they were shooting.
At the outlaws?
Certainly at the outlaws. Why?
I was just asking.
Look, are you the new sheriff?
No, ma'am.
Well, until you are, stop playing, sheriff.
I'd like to ask the same question she did.
What are you up to, Billy?
Maybe I've changed my mind about being sheriff.
And then I walked away from him.
Wouldn't look good to start off a new town government with a shooting scrape. Slim, your first job as sheriff would be the rest of those saddle tramps. We can take care of them later. Everything clear?
Yeah.
You'd better make a good sheriff, Slim.
You won't have any trouble from me.
That's fine. I don't think we'll have any more trouble from Harrison, either. Sloan, lock this up in the cell. Tell those suckers out there that Slim has been elected their new sheriff.
Are you going to stick around?
No. I'd better keep under cover until we take the town over. Janet and me are going up to the hideout. You boys come up later and let me know the results. Go on, go on, get going.
Bill, did you mean what you said a while ago?
Yeah, really? Gonna take on that sheriff job?
Still got my credentials.
Uh-oh. Here comes our friend.
Look! Let me have your attention, please. We have just counted the ballots, and Slim Jenkins here has been unanimously elected sheriff of Sage Valley. Congratulations, Sheriff.
He ain't on the level. He's fooling. Where's Harrison and what's he doing?
And to make it legal, here's a brand new bag. It's never been worn.
Hold it, son.
I think you've made a mistake. Mayor Harrison appointed me sheriff yesterday. Here's your authorization.
Why, yes, I think there has been a little mistake.
Drop your guns. I said drop your guns.
Nice work, Nick. Now you pin the badge back on the sheriff.
Sheriff is to arrest this man for the murder of Kim Vine.
That's the way to talk. Sloan's guilty and he'll hang. That's the kind of action we want.
You heard what I said, Sloan? You won't get away with this.
I'm doing all right so far. Get going.
Hey, Billy. What do you want done with these varmints?
Leave them. Come on.
Hey, he's doing all right for his part on cleaning up this town.
And with the authority vested in me, I hereby swear you in as sheriff of Sage Valley.
Now we got a real sheriff, boys. Sloan and his gang are through.
I don't know what to say, fellas, except I'll do my best.
Well, us ranchers are all with you. Run the varmints out of Sage Valley.
We know we can depend on you, Billy.
I guess I'd better get going, Mr. Harrison. I've got a prisoner to look after.
Well, if you need anything, call on me.
Thank you, sir. All right, fellas.
I think we made a good selection.
Except for that scar and that soup strainer he's got on his upper lip there, he's a spitting image of you, Billy.
Yeah, without that mustache, he looks enough like you to be your brother. Where'd you get this?
There's a whole bundle of them over there on the desk.
You know, I wonder we've been getting blamed for a lot of crimes with these posters floating around over the country. Any idea who he is?
Wouldn't be surprised if he's the one causing all the trouble around here. I had a brother. He died soon after I left home.
Boy, you had me going for a minute.
Yeah, me too.
I think this Kansas is the leader of the gang that killed the sheriff, held up the stage, and tried to kill Harrison when they stole his money.
Well, that adds up.
Let's go after him. You know, it's sort of be fun kind of rounding up those varmints.
Now, listen.
May I come in?
Come in.
I want to talk to you about Kansas.
Won't you sit down?
Thank you. You know about him.
We've heard a few things. What's on your mind?
Well, I've been talking to him, and he's decided to give himself up.
Nice girl.
Yeah.
You see, well, I've been in love with Kansas for a long time, and ever since we've met, I've tried to straighten him out and make him a law-abiding citizen, like you. And he'd never listened to me before, but now he's beginning to see things differently.
Well, you're open for business every day.
Just one thing. He wants to see you alone first, and that's just to talk things over.
I don't see what good.
Please do it for me. All I need is a little convincing, and of course, you don't know how much it means to me to get Kansas straightened out, but oh, please do it.
All right, I'll go with you.
Thanks, Billy. It won't take long, and you'll not be sorry for helping me.
Mind waiting a minute? Maybe a trap. I'm curious to hear what he has to say. Besides, I'd like to meet him.
How about $5? That's a trap.
At least I'm walking into it with my eyes open. If it's on the level, we can clean this town up. If it isn't, you boys know what to do.
Yeah, what kind of posies do you like?
Ready, Miss Janet?
You know, Fuzzy, this one don't add up.
What do you mean? That gal's doing a noble thing.
Yeah? No maverick was ever thrown or branded with words.
Funny business, Mr. Sheriff. Get his gun. Quite an actress, honey.
She sure is.
Said you wanted to have a talk.
Sure.
We'll have a talk. Janet, you and the boys go outside. Sheriff and I have got a little private business.
Okay.
Thanks for the double cross. Sit down, have a seat. Make yourself comfortable.
I'm all right here.
I said sit down. Everyone said we ought to meet.
I've heard the same thing. Seems like we met before.
First time I've been in this part of the country. Come from Kansas, don't you? Never mind where I come from. What do you want with me? Gonna play sheriff for a while. Let me have them clothes. Quick.
You know, Jeff, Billy ought to be back by now.
You want me to say I told you so?
If those Mavericks have done anything to him, why, I'll see in their eyes.
Well, Billy, it's about time you got back.
Never mind all that. Give me the keys. I'm releasing Sloan.
Sloan? Well, sure, Bill. I will. It's right here. But I thought we were holding him for trial.
No evidence.
What do you think, Jeff?
The same thing you do.
I'll see you boys later. What do you know about that?
I only know one thing. Something's happened to Billy.
Yeah, but what?
Why, if those varmints...
Come on, let's find him. Come on.
Our new sheriff for them crooks, and he released Sloan, too. It don't look right. Harrison ought to know about this.
Very clever, Sheriff.
What do we do now? Get busy on the ranch as I use.
They can't pay. You know what to do.
Right.
He sold out. That's what he done, and went over to Sloan's side.
I can't believe it.
We all saw it with our own eyes.
Where are those other fellows that were with him?
We went over to the sheriff's office, but they've skipped town. I tell you, Harrison, something's got to be done. Sloan's gave us 24 hours to pay up them IOUs. If we don't pay him, he's going to take our ranches. There's trouble brewing.
Well, there's something mighty funny about this whole thing.
We're not going to let him get away with it, Jed. Come on, man.
Wait.
We've waited too long now.
Well, where do we go now? We gotta keep looking, Fuzz. Come on. Hold it, Fuzz. Say, there's Billy's horse.
Yeah. Come on.
And release Sloan. We thought that.
I know.
We gotta
We don't want any more trouble.
Now, wait a minute. I'm your sheriff. This outfit here doesn't belong to us.
Yeah, we know all about that. You're mighty clever in changing around, but you ain't fooling us anymore.
Now, look, I'm trying to tell you that...
Come on, men. Bring them along. Come on, let's go.
Looks like we played the wrong cards.
I played them wrong by taking the sheriff's job.
Oh, they can't do nothing to us.
No, no?
No.
We'd be lucky if they don't hang us.
But Billy, with that Kansas fella running around loose, it looks
that's
like...
That's just it, Jeff. The ranch is convinced that I've been masquerading as bandit and sheriff. We'd be blamed for everything around here.
Well, I'm not going to take it laying down.
I knew it all the time. If you guys had listened to me, we'd have been on our way.
Oh, shut up, Fuzz. You're always moaning when we get into a jam.
Making a noise.
Wait here till Fuzzy brings Harrison and the ranchers.
You're not going in there alone.
Think I ought to get my clothes.
Well, I'm going with you.
I said wait here, Jeff.
Take my gun, Bill.
No, thanks. Don't think I'll need it. Inside?
Yeah, he's inside.
You see, we didn't finish our talk.
Hello, Kansas. Take it easy. Thought we'd finish our talk.
Sure, we'll talk. Leave us alone, Nick. But I have to say this fella's private. Tell the men outside to make sure he come along.
If you need me, I'll be right outside.
I don't think I'll need any help this time. Sit down.
What's on your mind?
I thought you and me ought to know each other a little better.
Sure. You don't very often find two fellows who look the same.
You know who I am?
Sure. You're Billy the Kid.
That's right. And you're Ed Bonney, my brother.
You're crazy.
Sit still.
Hold it. Get in here.
Found that fella sneaking around outside.
There's one more. His friend, the fellow with the whiskers. I think I know what's going on. Think you're pretty clever, don't you, Billy? But you're not clever enough. This other friend of yours is bringing the ranchers and Harrison. You thought you'd entertain me until they arrived. Get up. We're getting out of here, taking these two with us. Finish our business in town.
In town?
That's just where they won't be looking for us. Get going.
And surround the place.
Shh. Don't make any noise and we'll sneak in on them.
They've given us a slip and taken Billy and Jeff with them.
You mean they joined up with them? If there is two of them.
Why, sure, there's two of them. One of them's this Kansas Ed who's been doing all the murdering around here. The other one's my pal, Billy the Kid.
Billy the Kid, huh?
Now I know where I've seen him, but Billy didn't have nothing to do with it.
That's enough. Come on, men. Now we know what we're up against. Two of the worst outlaws in this country joined up. Come on.
Hey, no,
wait a minute. You're partnered up
the wrong tree.
Kansas, darling. Where
have
you been?
Hello, Kansas. You've got a lot to do.
Leave that saddle tramp out here. You don't believe in fighting fair, do you?
No.
But you can tell me about it sometime.
Harrison and the rancher just rode out of town an hour ago.
They're looking for us. When he comes back to town, we'll settle with him. From now on, this town's going to be run my way. This time, I'm staying. Come on in the office.
finish our little talk. Wait a minute, Slim. This is private. What gives you the crazy idea we're brothers?
For one thing, we look alike.
Yeah? What else?
Nothing in particular.
Now get this and get it straight. I'm not your brother and my name's not Bonnie. Made quite a reputation for yourself as Billy the Kid, haven't you?
You're doing all right yourself.
And I'm gonna do better. Thought you were gonna take over this town. You made a nice try getting appointed sheriff. But there's no room for the two of us around here. I'd like you to answer me just one thing.
Yeah?
What? Did Mom die before you left home?
Sorry, Ed. But from now on, things are going to be different with you, Mom, and me.
Mom?
Mom died a year ago. Yeah, but things will be different.
didn't know, Billy. It's all right, Jeff. Just got off on the wrong foot.
Well, Billy the Kid, you saved us the trouble of hanging your pal here. But you and the others will be dancing on the end of a rope. You thought you were pretty clever, didn't you? Well, you even had me fooled for a while. Come on, get moving.
You'll find Sloan and the others in the closet in the saloon.
You'll listen to me.
Yeah, if there is a next time. From the looks of it, we're going to end things right here.
I can't understand Harris turning on us.
What's the idea, Harris?
Never mind. Follow me.
Sure had us fooled, Mr. Harrison. It was the only way. I never could convince the ranchers that Billy the Kid wasn't in with Kansas and his gang. Well, you'd better get along before you run into any more trouble.
Hey, you don't have to tell me twice.
Just one more thing, Billy. You boys can always count on the mayor of Sage Valley if you ever need any help.
Thank you, Mayor. We won't forget.
So long.
So long, Mayor.